This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to explain the change of base rule for logarithms. So let's say you've got a logarithm like this one, log base 3 of 5, and you want to evaluate it. You want to find out approximately what it equals. Well, you won't be able to use your calculator for this because your calculator probably doesn't have a log base 3 function in it. But we can use the change of base rule so that you will be able to figure this out with a calculator. The change of base rule says I can take this logarithm and I can turn it into a fraction. The numerator of the fraction will be the log of 5, and the denominator will be the log of 3. So here's what I did. I took the number that I originally wanted to take the log of, that was log base 3 of 5. I took that 5, and I just wrote log of 5. That's the numerator. For the denominator, I took the base of the original function, that was this 3, and I used that for the denominator to find the log of that base, the log of 3. And now we've got the log of 5 over the log of 3. We could put this into the calculator as the log of 5 divided by the log of 3. And that would give us a decimal approximation for this original logarithm. So let me just explain why this works. If we take that original logarithm, the log base 3 of 5, and we say it equals x, then we can take this logarithm and we can convert it into its exponential form. We can convert that into 3, the original base, raised to the x power equals 5. And then once I've got that equation, that exponential equation, I can take the log of both sides. So I'm going to have the log of 3 to the x equals the log of 5. Now I've got a rule that says I can take this exponent and turn it into a coefficient. So instead of the log of 3 to the x, I'm going to have x times the log of 3 equals the log of 5. And then if I divide both sides by the log of 3, I'll have x equals the log of 5 over the log of 3, which is what the change of base rule said I would get. Okay? So that's basically the change of base rule and how it was derived. Let's just look at some problems now and make sure we know how to apply it. So here I've got the log base 1/2 of 17. I'm going to take that and turn that into the fraction, the log of 17 over the log of 1/2. And then to find out what that equals, in my calculator, I would enter the log of 17 divided by the log of 1/2. Next, I've got the log of 1.2, log base 1.2 of 7/3. So that's going to become the log of 7/3 divided by the log of 1.2. And once again, I could put that in my calculator as the log of 7/3 divided by the log of 1.2 and get my decimal approximation for this number. The last one I've got is the log base 4 of the square root of 11. So that's just going to become the log of the square root of 11 over the log of 4. And the calculator could handle that as well. Okay, that's basically how the change of base rule works. Take care. I'll see you next time.